Sprinkles, if you have any children, bears, or non-squeaky chairs in the room, please ask them to leave. I'm going to put on my Pikachu hat. Icosa could actually do a 100x from today and get to $20. I know. Whoa! That sounds stupid. No expectations. By the way, could go to zero tomorrow. By the way, if we lose all our money, suck it to both of us because it's imaginary Ponzi money. But I actually have critical information for you. You see, I discovered key pieces of information, which you guys all probably know, but I'm blessed I didn't discover this earlier because I would have went harder earlier. I know you like long and hard, friends. Of course, family friendly show. Shock the algorithm. Like, subscribe, bell button all. With Icosa, key information has come my way. Alex, I did not know, he was building a data center. He is still building it. It's been 63 weeks since this upload. I'm going to show it to you today. Now, why this is important is there is HEX staking. There is HEX, the contract. HEX, the monetary base. Icosahedron is an expansion pack to it. So when you stake HEX, you just go to the contract. But if you do a really long stake and it has to end, let's say there's a security breach or anything else, you can't do anything with your stake. You've got to click emergency end sell and it pays a huge penalty. With the Hedron staking, it turns your stake into a smart contract. And you can do an NFT from that. So you can then send your stakes away, okay? So we have the premise. We know Hedron and Icosa is useful. Now, where does Hedron come in play? Well, Hedron, the token, you know how you have your stake? Well, you can put it on an auction and sell it and buy it. But the currency to buy it is Hedron, HDRN. Now, where does Icosa come from? Well, Icosa, don't worry about where the yield comes from, but there's a missing piece. You see, there is no demand for Icosa yet. But we've already seen in August of last year, there was Alex's post where Alex mentioned that there's going to be an Icosahedron V2 update. It's actually meant to be, it's actually kind of overdue now, so it's going to take a while. But in this update, he's going to allow cross-chain staking, Pulse Chain and Ethereum. And also, friendly reminder, I made a video, I'm going to show with you more posts. The protocol, the new upgrade, we're going to have a 30-day window. The new upgrade is going to treat PICOSA and EICOSA the same. They're both going to be worth one unit. So in a nutshell, if you see PICOSA at 20 cents and EICOSA at 15 cents, you basically got a future arbitrage. Now, of course, it's no expectations. He's allowed to change it, but I'm just showing you how you can maybe get more bang for your buck. Now, where does this bring us to where we are today? Well, remember that that is the first upgrade coming and it should be done soon. And that'll be cool because there might be demand needed for Icosa now because Icosa doesn't have a missing demand. That's why I remember it's leverage on HEX, friends. And to stake cross-chain, there's probably going to be a fee required for Icosa paid every time. Maybe. I don't know exactly the mechanics, you know, whatever. But there's a step further than that. And Alex has been building a data center. And I'm actually going to show you the video right now. So this is Alex, and it was posted 63 weeks ago.
Guys, on the Pulse Chain data center in a while, so I thought I'd just give you guys a little tour of where we're at. Got the raised floor and the framing for the walls done. Next is drywall for those walls. Working on tearing out all of the electrical from the building and just doing all new, nicer panels. Starting to take delivery of all of the materials to put a new roof on and new siding. Goal is to have the first nodes up by the end of the year.
So just to share with you, strange things, right? But I'm just kind of telling you, friends, he's building a data center. It's for Pulse Chain nodes to have a lot of them running, etc. Now, this is where it's not even really a secret, friends. So we're not like throwing this out of absolutely nowhere, but you can connect the dots here. You can see that, well, he's got a data center and we've got an expansion pack to HEX. And we know the biggest use case on Ethereum today It is Lido down. It is staked Ethereum. And I can show that to you right now, friends. This is the DeFi Llama page for Ethereum. Look at Lido down. It has 23 billion put in there. 23 billion. Look what the second most amount is. It's MakerDAO, 8 billion. And then Aave, 6 billion. So by far, the biggest use case on Ethereum has not been done on Pulse Chain. It's a, like it's sitting low-hanging fruit. Kind of low-hanging fruit, but it's pretty complicated, okay? Because I'm just a peanut brain, friends. I just got a peanut brain. I've got a squeaky chair. I drink my protein shake. I've got a Pikachu hat, and that's it. Now, it doesn't take genius to figure it out, and basically they've hinted, friends. I'm just kind of like pushing it along. There will be, okay, so after this Icosa V2 upgrade, they're probably going to fork Rocket Pool. Now, Rocket Pool, Lido DAO, basically kind of the same thing. And effectively what it does is, for Pulse Chain, remember, you got to run a computer, a validator node, right? You've got to run your computer, and then you will receive the yield. And the yield is actually quite a lot. You can find the yield by going to gopulse.com. And if you go type in, go to the top, you will find the validators. See validators? See how that, look at the yield, man, 14%. Effectively, if you're running a computer node right now, every like validator, I forgot how much is in there, 32 million pulse, whatever. But you got to have a computer, you got to have internet set up, you actually got to be doing, you know, work. You're getting like one, more than 1% per month of a Pulse Chain yield, which means, right, if Rocket Pool or Lido DAO, whatever, if any of them got forked and they're used on Pulse Chain now, that means there will be a new token to buy, which mimics pretty much Pulse Chain. So it won't be called PLS, it'll be called RPLS. So it'll be like Rocket PLS, that's what it'll be called. Probably Rocket PLS, whatever they want to call it, okay? It could be like Staked PLS, doesn't matter, it's a derivative, and I can show you it now. If you go to CoinGecko, you can type, you see Lido Staked ETH, here you go. And you can see now it's very similar to the ETH price. So what it ends up doing is, it just ends up giving you, you can chart it in Ethereum, friends, and you can see over time, this thing is meant to be going up. You can remove the normal price here. And I forgot exactly how the staked Ethereum for this works, but you can even look at Rocket ETH. Let's look at, see, RETH. And RETH gives you the yield over time. What I'm going to do at the bottom is I'm going to look at the ETH ratio for it, and we put it on max. You'll be able to see the red line up top, friends? The red line on top, you can see it actually, right, it actually goes up and to the right. So that line that you can see, yeah, this is going up and to the right. So if you look at the left-hand side, friends, you can see this is 1.00 ETH. So you can see this line's going up and to the right. So basically, all it means is every single RETH you have, just by holding, you're earning yield. So you just go to the contract and you just withdraw it out. So if you bought today, like if you bought one Rocket Ethereum, whatever price is, one Rocket Ethereum, and then you waited a year, you don't need to wait a year, you can do it any day. Ethereum's yield is like 5%. So you get back 1.05 ETH worth, right? You get back 5% more. Fantastic. And you don't have 32 Ethereum. Most of you people don't have, and you don't even have a computer to do this and run it full time. So you can see this beautiful use case. Now, that staked coin as well, it opens up a lot of things because there's lending protocols, you know, like Liquid Loans will be able to take on staked Pulse Chain. There's lending protocols. There's people that just play with the yield and stuff. You do a lot of these mid-curve crazy things. Not crazy, but you end up playing around with it. Why? Because you deposit your Ethereum or your core coin, the collateral, and it can be a no-loss investment. But you are losing. You're just foregoing the yield. It would be the same as if I said, hey, give me 100,000 hex, and I guarantee you, you'll get back your 100,000 hex. And what I do in a year is I stake your short-term hex, and I try to use the money into, like, lottery tickets, okay? Now, I just use a very basic, that's me, that's your friend Swami here throwing that. But this is what these DeFi mid-curve protocols do. They'll take your Ethereum and basically no loss. Well, you can gamble only on the yield part. So I guess it's safe, right? But that comes later. That's what we see now on layer 2, Arbitrum and Ethereum. You can see like they have like all these mid-curve people doing these and it kind of expands Ethereum. But we don't really, that's not the real juice. That is because the low-hanging fruit's gone. But we haven't even got to there on Pulse Chain. That's how early we are. Pulse Chain's really, really new friends. We're not even a year old in Pulse Chain. So we are at this point where you can see that, there is big potential, right? So you have a staked Pulse Chain use case that's needed. You have Alex, who Richard Hart likes, calls him smart. One of the only dudes I've ever heard him call smart, by the way. Richard Hart's only called Elon Musk smart, Vitalik a genius, and I've heard him say about Alex. Doesn't compliment anyone. Literally doesn't compliment anyone. So pretty cool, right? The third, that missing feature of Icosa is important. And that's what we're here. We're here to speculate on us. That's why when I see a chart, I know like, yeah, all right, we've got the Icosa hex ratio, but I know you really don't care about that, right? Because I'd rather just give you the simple number with how high these things go. I'm just telling you how they're derived. So if we find the way to get this back to the ceiling price, that's basically Alex's goal. How can Icosa get back to the ceiling price versus hex? That's a 4x, by the way, against hex. Now, here's the thing. If hex goes back to its all-time high, the combined hex, that's a 20x. So if you do 4 times 20, friends, that's an 80x. You're going to do 80 to 100x. And if you do that on 20 cents, that's $16-ish, 16 to 20 bucks. I know these numbers are like, whoa. Yeah, man, this is how you get it. This is how you get it. So you need some things to play out. Now, where does it all come to play? Well, one of the additional things for Icosa that they can do is with Rocket Pool, you got to buy Rocket Pool and lock it up for collateral. Because here's the thing, because if you have a computer and you have like a hardware, right, like what Alex has building this warehouse, with Rocket Pool, what you can do is you run your computers, you buy and stake Rocket Pool, and then everyone will join your system and you're handing out yield to everybody. But what you're doing is you're taking a cut. So, you know, remember with Ethereum, it's very tight. It's like, okay, the Ethereum yield is 5%. And I think for like staked Ethereum, you'll get 4.5%. So they'll just take 0.5 out of it, which is, it's decent. I mean, without them, you wouldn't have any yield, right? So that's another component that they could play around with. And so in terms of, well, imagine they required you to buy Icosa to stake it. Now, that would be meaning every single person with a validator, they're incentivized now. If they ran the service for Icosa, they're getting all our bonus yield given to them over time. And we don't really care because, like, right now, if you hold Pulse in your wallet, you get no yield. But it's handing out 14% APR. Now, don't get too panicked. I mean, we're less than a year old. We're so early. So wouldn't it be great, right? Let's say the yield stayed at 14%. Now, it's going down over time. But let's say next year it's 12% and this thing has come out. It'd be great, right? Imagine if you and I, just holding it, we got 10%. And then the extra 2% of all of us is given out to the people running the validators and it's extra income for them. But for them to participate, they would have to buy and hold Icosa. You see that demand part? They have to lock it in. Now, if you're looking at this, you go, well, there's a lot of ifs and maybes and roadmaps here and there. That's the thing. And yeah, you should know by now, friends, I'm wearing a Pikachu hat. But if you honestly want to wait until all of this is done and then there are clearer things, good freaking luck. You see how thin this liquidity is? Look at here, man. Icosa's got a 5 million market cap. Its liquidity is only like, that's 80K on the offers. Like, you got nothing. Good luck. These things going to fly. You can't, right? So you can't rely on that. That's why these things, that's why lottery tickets, you can increase your probability. Now, Alex is a very honest man. Like, you read people, friends. He's an honest dude. He's a good, kind-hearted dude. He completely avoids price speculation. He completely avoids people trying to game the system. He makes it fair and open and everything. And yeah, it's everything's done by the book and it's for open public markets and everything. It's very like Richard Hart-esque. There's no like, you know, exploitation of anything on it. It's very clean, very pure. Obviously, and you can never really know. You can't really trust anyone but yourself. But You just, it seems like, all right, it's worth it to me. Now, if we look at this, I'll show you ICOS to HEX ratio just so you can see how these things are derived. But let's go into the USD price so you can visualize it. You know, a lot of people, I know, man, you guys put it on a one hour chart and you, all you guys see is this. You go, oh my God, we've gone up a lot. But Habib, okay. Look where ICOSA was. Look at this thing. We'll zoom in. Do you want to know where ICOSA was when HEX was last time 3 cents in August? ICOSA was $1.38. This is PICOSA, by the way. It went all the way down. So it freaking dropped, friends, 99%. Okay, so we're just coming up off the floor. 5 million market cap. It's obviously very, very low. So remember, I said these are leverage on the Pulse Chain, and not just Pulse Chain, or altcoins and ecosystems. Yeah, leverage. If you were to time it by looking at the charts, you just start getting in Bitcoin halving year. Surprise, surprise. Luckily for you, you watch me with a very straight posture, wearing a Pikachu hat, informing you, hello, friend, the calendar has ticked over. It's now 2024. It's now time to take all these altcoins seriously. Sure, you got your poopy McPoop coins over there. You got your other meme coins out there. But this is something, obviously, it's more, dare I say, serious with like backing and stuff. And just to let you know, with Ethereum, when you see more like serious backing stuff like this, it doesn't mean they necessarily pump forever or anything different happens. But there is something I've noticed in the charts. The downside volatility is a bit more reduced. And it kind of makes sense, right? Because think about, like, you could go buy some poopy meme coins, but the people trying to buy this, they're like, they've invested more time learning about it. They go, okay, sweet, I'm here long term. And it's a reflection of Alex's maybe like stable personality as well. So it's not, you're probably not going to see like these outrageous moves on the way up. But I made like almost, I think I made like, I'm literally like 100x on Rocket Pool. And I'm going to show you what Rocket Pool did. Now, Rocket Pool here, I'm going to bring it out for you. Put a weekly chart. There you go. I learned about Rocket Pool down here. And I was like, oh, sweet. I like your... No, right here. I was like, oh, sweet. I like your logo. Whee! There's 100x, friends. There's 100x. Okay, sold my last part here. And I know, I'm just... I'm telling you, I fluked it. I just set up here like, that's it. I'm done, guys. So let's put on a log chart. You can see the potential here, man. This is big. Rocket Pool doing straight 100x. That's 150x over the cycle. You know, this wasn't even the ICO, man. If you want to go to the bottom of it, I mean, it went up. Wow, went up 466x. You know what I'd like to do with you now? Please, with your permission, I'm going to go look up what Rocket Pool's market cap valuation is on CoinGecko. And we can see it. Its market cap is $600 million. This is Rocket Pool. All right, $600 million. It's TVL. So don't worry about this total value lock. This TVL, it has nothing to do with it, really. TVL is like how much Ethereum is committed to it. It really has nothing to do too much with the coin, but it's relevant to show you if something's popular or not. So if Rocket Pool is $600 million today, and ICOSA, because remember, friends, we're like when it comes to, like, you know, Richard Hart and Alex, there's no like, oh, okay, let's do a private ICO and only let insiders in. They don't do that. If it's going to work out, it's going to be like this. And if Alex was to do this, maybe he's listening to this, I don't know, but if he was to do this, he knows this, it has to be done like this. It's no expectations. It's you're either on board or you're not. He's not here to hold your hand. He's not here giving you updates every 14 minutes. Like, oh, golly gee, please don't sell. Please don't sell. He's not here to do that. It's either you're in or you're out. You're my friend or you're non-friend, all right? Now, I've got a Pikachu hat. You're my friend. And that's the way it's got to be. So if Rocket Pool is $600 million, then I'm just wondering, right, if Pulse Chain gets, like, if we're meant to be a tenth of that, just guessing, right? If Ethereum, you know, whatever Ethereum's stake things are, that's where I want to look at the valuation. But what you might do is, you might go, wait a minute. If we're doing Rocket Pool, what if Alex is the only staked version with the coin here? What I'm trying to do is trying to guess like a future valuation for where we land and as a relative value. So if we look at Lido DAO, the coin, as well. That's another coin. Lido DAO. So remember, Rocket Pool is $600 million. Lido DAO is 2.5 billion. So now we have this number. We've gone, okay, those types, now there's others here, but it's about 3 billion. And what I want to do is go, well, if you do a 90% discount on that, because Pulse Chain's not going to be, it's going to be like maybe 1/10 of Ethereum-ish, hopefully, okay? What would that be? By the way, if Pulse Chain got to Cardano today, we would be about 1/10 of Ethereum, just to let you know. So it's kind of adding up. So if we do 1/10 of 3 billion, it lands us at about 300 million valuation. And iCosa today, EICosa, PICosa, I think it's about 10 million-ish. So talking about the upside, from 10 million to 300 million, it's the 30x from today. So if you bought even earlier with me, friends, like, congratulations. I've been buying the whole way. But that's big from here, a 30x from here. And obviously, we're throwing numbers on a dartboard. We're literally monkeys. We've got no idea, friends. Like, they bought Dog with a hat, 14,000x. Look at that technology, right? You know, so just trying to put pieces of puzzle together. But just giving you something to dream about. That's what we're doing. A 30x times today's price, right? It'll be like, yeah, there you go, $6 each. There you go. So more of it, though, relies on the HEX price and how it flourishes. And, you know, these things, by the way, they are not even at their potential. That's today's price. That's 2 days. I looked at Rocket Pool and Lido DAO. What if Ethereum doubles and then these things go up another 4x? That means that $6 ICOSA, do like a 3 or 4x on it, it ends up around $18 to $24. I know these numbers sound big, but now you get to see where it's coming from. And of course, that's why lottery tickets, they can go a very long way. You're in the Pulse Chain ecosystem, you want leverage on HEX, and now you're in this ICOSA thing, which most no one knows. I know, friends, it's very complicated sometimes, but I'll just figure it out here for you. Where you're like, okay, the founder has got a data center, there's a big use case to have stake Pulse Chain. Everyone's going to use it. I'll tell you right now, every single person is going to use stake Pulse Chain. There is no reason to have non-staked Pulse Chain after that. None. Because you're earning 1% yield every month. Right? So if you have, look, think about that, man. If you have 100 million HEX, 100 million Pulse, if you had 100 million of the staked, the Rocket Pulse, the staked Pulse, in 1 month, you have an extra 1 million, right? And you just throw that out and just throw some lottery tickets. Like, the use case is huge, especially in these early years. It's like, wow, it's fantastic. You get to really be the miner now. So you get to hold. See, if you want to do this with HEX, you get to stake it. But now this opens up the possibilities, right? So this is beautiful. It also might make it even more competitive for PulseX. Even though PulseX, yeah, gets a buy and burn, but this thing, you're earning yield just holding it, you know? So it makes these things, just enhances everything for us. Now, of course, I'm just going to do show you how far the moon math arrow is for us to go to the targets. I mean, this is where, friends, this is where 10 bucks is. Look where you can't even see it on the screen. So you just don't know with these. You just don't know. We need a lot of things to play out, of course. You need Bitcoin and Ethereum to not die. We need Pulse Chain, PulseX, and HEX to keep going up. You need HEX to recover too. You need Alex to keep building. You need ICOSA Hedron update to come in. And then we need more confirmation, like this data center is going to happen. It's going to take time. It's going to be a roadmap. Look at the Rocket Pool one, man. 2019, 2020, you know, 3 years of that. So it's a journey, though. It's a journey to participate. It's great. Can earn yield along the way. It's nice, though, right? Wouldn't you rather me tell you this while there's a chance here, in case this works out, right? I'd rather know about it now. I'd rather know about it now, because this is absolutely insane, insane returns from here if this works out. I mean, like, think about it, man. Look, this is life-changing, literally life-changing, because here's the thing, man. Just imagine Richard Hart puts Pulse Chain, PulseX, and HEX higher than what you and I think is possible. Just think about that. So if that happens, what's going to happen to the leverage coins? We'll literally be the best ecosystem in crypto. Okay, for every single person. So this is, you know, that's why you don't know these things are coming, but it helps if you're in the depression. Because even if we get nice, stable, blue chip returns, cookie cutter returns, they're still beautiful. So what did you think about that, friends? Of course, it's speculation and roadmap, whatever, but this is how the game works for you and me, because there are no insiders and this like secret cabal and this shadowy room of these ICOs. This is just how it has to be. This is actually just, it's Richard Hart style. Richard doesn't hold your hand saying, there will be PulseX limit orders in 6 months. Please do not dump. This is your friend Richard Hart. He doesn't say that. He says, get out. I'm better than you. I've got a big wee-wee and a big PP. But he tells people that. He's like, oh, sweet, you're going to think of selling? Get out. And then he bridges like $20 million, you know, 3 months later so he can buy it up. That's actually healthier for everybody else. Okay, so I've given you all the tools you need now. I've shown you ICOs to HEX ratio. I've actually shown you, friends, you see the story of everything playing out. You don't need to know any of it. I showed you the chart. The first thing I did, I showed you the chart. I go, sweet, if we go back to the ceiling and HEX is back to 50 cents, we are up 80X. That's it. That's all you need to know. That's literally all you need to know. So you go, oh, sweet, 80X is the upside, and maybe divide it by 4 just in case we don't get it. Okay, it's a 20X from here. So you go, sweet, 20X is still pretty good. That's still worth it to me. And then you put like a lottery ticket in, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You get the point, okay? That's all you need to know. Everything else out there, I'm just helping you build conviction to hold. So that first part, friends, lottery tickets can be thrown everywhere. But the next part, I've shown you like, I wonder if it's worth more than just one lottery ticket. You see, we're trying to increase our probability that we win. Okay, now, this is a very, very unique case. It's come upon us. Let's see how the price action goes, right? I don't even think everything needs to be released. It just, over time, things happen. Prices go up. Remember, before any of these were out, the ICOs to HEX ceiling was, you know, it was at 36, right? It's still at like 11. And by the way, the ceiling's up to like 50 something now. So this is like no use case at all. It's just the market opening there. I think it's fantastic that we have this opportunity. You're my friend. Share with your friends and family. Please don't just go out and FOMO anything. You put the ratio up. Is it in the box? That's it. I'm going to tell you right now, though, it's still going to go up even without me, friends. It's still going to go up. It's just going to do more of this, probably. And then there'll just be like a higher floor. Why? Because maybe ICOs of V2 gets released here and does a higher floor, and it's around here. And then, who knows, maybe in a year, Alex says, all right, I'm going to actually fork Rocket Pool. You know, hopefully he says it earlier. But you see what I mean? And then it starts going up like that. That's maybe what happens. We want the spike up faster, though. But just showing you, you can't wait too long for these. It is what it is. You put it in, but just, you know, I've hinted to you. Okay, yeah, there's lottery tickets to be thrown around. Like, yeah, Pikachu coin, these other little meme coins here and there, and they're fun and they're great and they can pump. But if this works out, because we can see the vision, and I've shown you, you know, long-term stake hexing and stuff, all of this compounds and feeds in itself, I think you would regret just leaving one lottery ticket into this, all right? I've shown you a lot, friends. I'm still wearing a Pikachu hat, okay? If it goes to zero tomorrow, I don't know what to tell you. You're always going to be my friend. There's a bull market coming. Let's hope we make it to the end. Make sure you like, subscribe, belly button, all. Catch you very soon.